Good morning, my dear students. Today we are discussing about the last part in the aquaculture chapter, that is freshwater pearl culture. So you already know that pearl is a natural gem and it is produced by a mollusca. India is importing a large quantity of cultured pearls every year from the international markets to meet the domestic demand. The Central Institute of Freshwater Aquaculture, ICFA, Bhubaneswar, has developed technology of freshwater pearl culture from common freshwater mussel, which is widely distributed in freshwater bodies throughout country. A natural pearl is of small size and irregular shape. But the cultured pearl is also a natural pearl, but the only difference that is being human intervention in surgical implantation of a live mantle graft and a nucleus for hastening pearl formation to the desired size, shape, color as well as the luster. In India, three species of commonly available freshwater mussel, that is Lamnedens marginalis, then Lamnedens coriens and Parasia corgata can be used to produce good quality of pearls. So, the technology behind culturing of freshwater, that is pearl. In nature, a pearl is formed when a foreign particle, that is piece of sand, insect, etc., by chance enter into the body of the mussel. And the mussel cannot throw that out, and instead it makes a shiny coat on the particle layer by layer. This simple phenomenon is being exploited in pearl culture practices. So the freshwater pearl culture operation, which involves six major steps. In that, first one, that is collection of mussels. Second one, pre-operative conditioning. Third, implantation of grafts and nuclei. Next, that is post-operative care of mussels. Next, pond culture of implanted mussels. Next one, that is harvest of mussels and pearls. These are the six major steps which are involved in freshwater pearl culture. Collection of mussel. First one, that is the healthy mussel, should be collected manually from the freshwater bodies like pond, river, etc., and they have to be kept in buckets or containers having water. The ideal mussel size should be used for pearl culture, that is of 8 to 10 centimeter. You can see in the picture. The second step, that is pre-operative condition. So the name itself has its meaning, before. So pre-operative condition. So the collected mussel should be kept in crowded condition in captivity. That is one mussel per liter of water with tap water for pre-operative conditioning for around 2 to 3 days. This pre-operative condition help in weakening of adductor muscles for easy handling during surgery. So the next step, that is muscle surgery. So the raw material required during surgical implantations are beads or nuclei, which are usually made from molluscan shell or other calcareous material. Depending on the place of surgery, the implantation are of three types, that is mantle cavity implantation, second one mantle tissue implantation, third one, that is gonadal implantation. So these are the three important surgery which is helped in implantation. First, that is mantle cavity insertion. Second, that is mantle tissue implantation, has been divided into non-nucleated and nucleated. Third one, it is gonadal implantation. So the product obtained from all these three implantation, that is mantle cavity insertion, the product that is usually it is a pearl, but the design pearls, half round pearls will be obtained in case of mantle cavity insertion. Second method, that is mantle tissue implantation. So in that case, non-nucleated. So the product obtained will be free irregular small pearls, whereas in case of nucleated, the product obtained, that is a small round pearls. And third one, that is the conoidal implantation. So in that, the product obtained, that is irregular free round pearls, they are obtained in case of gonadal implantation. So now we'll see the different types of implantation. In that first one, mantle cavity implantation. So after opening the two valves, that is without causing injury to muscle at both the ends of animal, and they are carefully separated, the mantles of the anterior side from the shell by the help of surgical set. So in that, first thing you have to open the two valves. In this procedure, around that is 4 to 8 mm diameter are designed, that is images of any beads, they are inserted into the mantle cavity region of muscle. That means the skin-like structure which are covered on each side of the body of muscle. You can see in the picture the different parts which are found in the shell. So implantation could be done in mantle cavities of both the valves. So in case of implantation of designed beads, care should be taken that designed portion faces the mantle. After placing the bead in desired place, the gaps created during implantation should be closed by pushing the mantle on the shell. The second type, that is mantle tissue implantation. Here, the muscles are divided into two groups, that is the donor and the recipient, that means who gives and who receives. The first step in the procedure is preparation of graft, that means a small pieces of mantle tissue. So this is done by preparing a mantle ribbon, a strip of mantle along the ventral side of the muscle, from the donor muscle which is sacrificed, and cutting that into a small pieces, that is 2 into 2 mm. The implantation is done on recipient muscle, which is of two types, that is as we discussed earlier, non-nucleated and nucleated. In the former, only the graft pieces are introduced into the pockets created at the inner side of posterior palatal mantle present at the ventral region of the muscle. In the nucleated method, a graft piece followed by a small nucleus that is of size 2 mm diameter is introduced in the pockets. In both the procedure, care should be taken that graft or nucleus does not come out of the pocket. Implantation could be done at mantle ribbon of both the valves. So this is the type, that is mantle tissue implantation, where it consisting of, that is donor and the recipient muscle, and along with that, so that implantation is done on recipient muscle, which is of two types, either it may be non-nucleated or it may be nucleated. The third one, that is gonadal implantation. This procedure also involves preparation of similar to mantle tissue method, that is the first one. First, a cut is made at the edge of the gonad of the muzzle. Then a graft is inserted into the gonad followed by nucleus, and that nucleus it is about 2 to 4 mm diameter, so that the nucleus and graft are in close contact. Care should be taken that nucleus that touches the outer epithelial layer of the graft and the intestine is not cut during the surgery. This is the third implantation, that is gonadal implantation. So the next step, that is post-operative care. So after operation or after surgery, that care, what we call it as post-operative care. So once the muscle has been implanted, that is kept in post-operative care unit in nylon bags for 10 days with antibiotic treatment and supply of natural food. The units should be daily examined, and the dead muscle and the ones that are rejected, the nucleus that should be removed. So the next step, that is pond culture. After post-operative care, the implanted muscle should be stocked in the ponds by keeping them in nylon bags, that is 2 muscle per bag, and hanging from bamboo or PVC pipes and placed in pond at 1 meter depth. The muscle all are cultured at stocking density of 20 to 30,000 muscle per hectare. You can see in the picture. The pond should be periodically fertilized with organic manure and inorganic fertilizer to sustain the plankton productivity. The periodical chucking of muscle with removal of dead ones and cleaning of bags should be carried out throughout the culture period of about 12 to 18 months. So the last part, that is the pearl harvest. The muscle should be harvested at the end of the culture period. So the individual pearl can be taken out from the mantle tissue or the gonad of the live muscle. So the muscle are sacrificed in case of mantle cavity method. The products obtained through different implantation method vary. In the mantle cavity method, that is the first method, these are shell attached, that means they are half round pearls which are obtained in mantle cavity method. Second one, in mantle tissue method, as they are unattached to the shell, they are small, irregular or round pearls, whereas in gonadal method, as unattached to the shell, the pearl which is obtained or big, irregular or round pearls. So this is about the culturing of freshwater pearls. Thank you.